Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum, dear students. This session focuses on second language acquisition and sociolinguistics, the case of Japanese. I hope and expect by the end of this session, you will be able to understand the SLA context in Japan. Well, my dear students, why I have chosen the case of the Japanese nation with reference to SLA, because I have already presented the case of Pakistan to you, and I hope you understand how Pakistani context has certain connotations and contexts attached to that. So it would be a good idea to have a completely different picture of it to compare and to contrast in order to understand that. I would also like to make clear that there are two types of non-English speaking countries that are affected by this global one language policy of the American Empire. And as a result of that, English is being learned and taught as a lingua franca across the globe. And in a lot of countries, it is being taught as a second language, you know, as well. So, you know, this SLA perspective in various countries is then affected by that. Some of these choose English as a means of, out of these two groups in which I have divided it, some of them choose it as a means of international communication for economic benefits. For example, the cases of Japan and Scandinavia. So that is why I have taken this case of Japan. As compared and contrasted to this, there are other English, you know, learning environments in different countries where English is imposed on them through the colonial rule. For example, Pakistan, India, or some, you know, Nigeria, some other African countries, etc. So, you know, because you yourselves have the experience of the context of this kind of group with colonial experience, it would be a good idea to have the experience of, you know, Japan as belonging to the other kind of group. So when it comes to the case of Japan, I would say the status of English in Japan has certain significant and unique features. English language is taught in Japan as a second language, and there are certain, you know, issues related to English as, you know, a second language. The Japanese language itself has developed and is embedded in a particular kind of Japanese social system and social setup. So, you know, Japanese people speaking English should still be communicating through their unique Japanese and Eastern perspective, because the sociolinguistic approach towards SLA believes that it is the socially oriented context in which the linguistic input operates, and thus SLA takes place, or second language acquisition takes place. So Japanese language itself and the Japanese sociocultural context has its own peculiarities which cannot be separated from it when it comes to SLA, second language acquisition processes with reference to the learning of English. Well, what is the real debate? The debate is English can be taught through discussions of famous Japanese individuals, Japanese historical events, and the significance of Japanese traditions. This is the debate that you would find all over in Japan when it comes to academic contexts, when it comes to the concerns of the educationists or researchers in the field of academics, etc., or even the policymakers, you know, in Japan with reference to education. Because, you know, again, there are two ways of giving this input of, you know, English language. One way of giving that input, you know, can be that, you know, the contents that are taught in the second language learning process, the contents would be based on, for example, the foreign experiences, for example, on American holidays, on the religious rituals of individuals who are famous in, you know, in the English, native English speaking community from the USA or from the UK, etc. And, you know, by learning those, by exploring those contents that are based on these kinds of events and social setups, etc., the Japanese children would learn this language. This is one approach towards SLA, where bringing in the native environment of the of the second language that is to be taught is considered to be significant. However, in Japanese context, the debate is that instead of, you know, introducing these kind of contents that are borrowed from, you know, the native English speaking world, why not to use the contents that are locally established where the language input is of English. However, you know, the festivals, the activities, the norms, the values, the celebrities, etc., the individuals who are introduced and about whom, around whom, you know, these lessons are designed, these contents are designed, they should be embedded in the Japanese culture. So, you know, this particular perspective that the Japanese SLA processes take is in contrast with the traditionally taken perspective by many other countries where, you know, exposure to the culture of the native, you know, English-speaking people, exposure to their norms, values, cultures, events, etc., is considered to be very appreciative, and to children at the very early stages of, you know, their education, at the very low level, you know, at the elementary level, they are exposed to their culture, and through exposure to the culture, you know, they are given exposure to English language. However, as I've already said, when it comes to the case of Japan, there are certain concerns with reference to that. And why there are concerns? Because Japanese people, and especially young learners in Japan, they are already being influenced by the Western culture and values. And the concern is that not to reinforce those values or those, you know, ways of living or that culture through English language. There are certain, you know, ideas of serious national reflection on these ideas. However, you know, when it comes to the concerns of educators and, you know, researchers, that is one end of the story. On the other hand, their reflections may not, you know, in one day change the national policy. But of course, this would give rise to a kind of awareness of the situation and the factors that you know, influence the SLA processes. And this would also give rise to a kind of awareness, you know, in terms of government's consciousness while taking decisions in this regard. So, you know, there are major, you know, debates with relevance to, you know, the methodology that is to be used in the Japanese classroom to receive a formal English language training, to get an input at the junior and the high school levels, because in one thing they resemble the Pakistani context, that despite, you know, English as SLA being acquired at English as second language being acquired at the primary levels and continued through the higher levels, high school level, you know, the performance when it comes to conversation abilities, when it comes to skills performance, the Japanese students are performing poorly on that. So probably partly it is a result of the archaic grammar translation method that is used there. And why it is actually so, there are certain other reasons as well. Grammar translation methodology would have worked well in Meiji's period 1866 to 1912. But it does not serve the language needs of today's Japan, where, you know, cultural influence of the West already exists. Secondly, the low performance, and this is a very important point, students, because secondly, the low performance of the Japanese students in terms of speaking English, particularly with reference to skills, is considered to be related to the influence of the first language. How? Because in Chinese culture, the culture is intrinsically entwined in ritual, style, and form. And in many circumstances, form in which sometimes something is uttered is important rather than the words themselves. So, you know, the sociolinguistic scene, the sociolinguistic norms of Japan, they reinforce the idea of focusing on, you know, what you may call ritual and style than on form. form of the language. So, you know, the natural result of that is that by the age of puberty, young Japanese children or students, they are cognizant of the importance of form, importance of style. You know, they give more importance to style. They do not focus on form. The natural result is when it comes to, you know, SLA, again, their focus does not remain on form, on structure, on learning the language itself. Their more focus is on style. So this is one of the unique aspects of English, you know, and SLA, that is second language acquisition, in the Japanese context.